Just who are these people grabbing these packages? Well, it's middle class India. And surprise, surprise, it's the Indian middle class, which is counted amongst the number one shoppers in cities like Singapore, Dubai, London, and even Switzerland.
Holidaying at the beaches of Goa is a thing of the past, and meandering through palaces and the havelis of Rajasthan is also passé. For a good chunk of Indian travellers, especially the middle class, the definition of holidaying is now changing. So whether it's the exotic locales of Thailand or the gold souks of Dubai or the delights of Disneyland or for that matter shopping malls of Singapore, Indians are travelling everywhere. Call it a newly found passion or an attitudinal change. Indian travellers are now spending more on trips abroad. The average amount spent daily by a person is between $75 and $200, with hotel choices varying from 3 to 5 stars. A higher disposable income, a new mindset to pamper oneself, the affordability quotient that is offered by numerous holiday packages and cheaper fares from various airlines are some of the reasons.
People who are in the IT industry, the software industry, these are young people who are just fresh from college and they are getting good salary package. So, I mean, a person who is getting 20-30,000 rupees as a start or 40,000 rupees and two people get together and, you know, it's a lot of money.
And it is not just one trip abroad. There are people who take two or three brief vacations each year. It has now become a status symbol for most families in India.
Easier bank loans for holidays and more countries having visa relaxation for Indian families is further boosting the outbound travel industry.
Around 7 million Indians travelled abroad last year, which is double the number for the tourists coming to tour India. The outbound tourist industry is growing by 25% every year. But what's pushing a sudden growth in the outbound tourism industry?
There is now foreign exchange freely available. And the Indian credit card is acceptable abroad. So, I mean, you can virtually spend your money in rupees and later on the banks do the transaction. So, this problem is not there. Jo pehle thi ke bhai you get only $500 or $1,000 in foreign exchange.
So, with sun shining bright in most of India, guess it's time to pack your bags and put on your globe-trotting shoes. With Yamini in Delhi, Priyanka Nath, Headlines Today.